shimikaze, where you actually change your hands and moves. And what's most important about katsuguruma is probably the positioning, more so than the execution, because once you get the positioning, it's just a drop at the end, okay? So in this, in katsuguruma, okay, we step forward, and we step at just up, so about 1 meter apart. And reach up here and grab, okay? And in this kata, we take one step, two, and this time, as the second step, we rotate from here to here and grab, all right? On the third step, we take a big step back, shoot in across here, pull here, right? This hand doesn't grab. A lot of people come here and grab. This hand comes right here, right? But you've got to make sure that you're not up here and trying to grab this here. I can't lift. I've got to be here, across here, and then lift. Okay. So when I come here, this hand here, my head is going to be right here next to the hip, okay? So I'm here like this, crossed here. I lean the body out and lifting this way. And this comes up and this shakes. From here and then boom. Okay? Now, if you got someone your size or bigger, be careful, okay? It's almost better to have someone a little slender when you're practicing the Torii, okay? But point of it is that you can take a big person with this technique as long as you get proper fitting. You have three parts of the throat. Kazushi, Sukuri, and in this case, Kaki execution. All right, so let's do it again. We're just going to do this in the center. So, just like this. So just kind of hold yourself out there and ready to finish yourself. Each knee, sun, right here, okay, here. I step in, cross here, leading out, cross here, and I want to place the hand here. Cross, right? Now, I've got to make sure that I'm in close here, cross, leading out, so when I lift, I'm not hurting my back, okay? I'm lifting my legs. Okay. So let's go ahead and pair up. Go ahead.
Uki, on the videos we've seen, Uki will often, as you reach under, as your head goes near my belt, Uki will often kind of Superman forward and kind of spread a little bit. So like
that. You have to be careful, because Uki is being pulled, and they are like this, right? Okay. But you have to be careful in kata that you don't spring forward and make an acrobat bent. Because in jiu-jitsu dual competition, for example, a lot of times people go out there and, you know, the guy that's, boom, and all of a sudden, but he's flying across the room, you know? It's got to be done realistically.
He's got so strong chi.
Yes, and you keep your mouth off from the body up. But you've got to be careful not to throw yourself. But we have a word in Japanese called stemmy. Stemmy means, you know, you're springing a little bit, okay? Stemmy is a springing out as he lifts. Okay. And that has to be a coordinated practice, okay? For kata purposes. Are we on short time?
No, you got till 5 after 3.
5 after 4, you mean 4. Okay. Okay.